A new feature available for the September 2017 update release is the ability to control the layout of your HTML pages using a grid mode wizard. This video will demonstrate how to configure current and new grid row elements in MPainter. So to enable grid mode, you'll click the layout button in the ribbon bar of your menu and click toggle grid mode. Once enabled, you'll see the page is separated out into different sections. Hovering over a different section will highlight that particular row as the active row. Right-clicking in an active section will give you the layout options. Here I'll choose the configure row layout. You'll see now that you can choose between the different configured row layouts. After selecting the layout of your choice, you're then taken to a new screen where you can choose between where the contents of the current layout will go into the different section of your new layout. Do this by dragging the contents box to the desired location of your new layout. Click OK to save, and you'll see now that the title row is separated into two different sections. On the left-hand side shows the original contents of the layout, and on the right-hand side we have a new placeholder where we can add any new content that we want. So let's say we want to include a welcome message, a welcome user message on this side of the screen. So I can type in something like welcome, and then insert the common field for the user. And then maybe I want to use my formatting tool to put that on the right side. So when I save and I execute this application, I can now see that my user is on the right-hand side where I added it and in the location that I wanted it to be. Let's go back to MPainter. We'll add more to this application. Importing applications is a very common task when it comes to MPainter, but controlling where that imported application is displayed can sometimes be tricky. This grid mode wizard makes this much easier by allowing the developer to choose where to insert that row to hold the import. So here I'll toggle my grid mode again. And what I want to do is I want to insert an import right above this main table in my application. So I'll hover over my table and make sure that the row is highlighted. And I'll go to grid row options, and I'm going to insert a row above this. Now, I could choose insert the row below or inside, but what I want to do is just insert it above. Now you can see that there's a blank grid row available right above that current the table. And so here I can go and I can insert the import that I want to have in my application. So now you can see the import is there. If I save and I execute, I can see that the imported table is lined up perfectly with the parent application's table, just the way I want to see it. Now lastly, included in this new grid row layout enhancement is the ability to view the source code of a specific section of your HTML page. Previously, you were able to view and narrow down the HTML to see the source cells or rows, but you were not able to view the source code in a specific section outside of a table. So now you have the ability to switch to grid mode and really pinpoint and view the source code of a specific section by going to the grid row options, and you can edit row HTML or the column HTML. And again, you're pinpointing that specific section of the HTML instead of viewing the full source, which can sometimes be overwhelming. Now finally, I want to mention that all of the latest versions of modern browsers support this new grid layout function or feature, except for Internet Explorer 11. IE 11 does not support the required CSS standards in order for this feature to work. So if you try to open up the grid layout in IE 11, so let me switch to IE 11 here, and you try to open up the grid layout, it's going to prompt you and warn you that it's disabled for IE 11, and it'll suggest you using a more modern browser like Chrome, Firefox, or Edge. Now, with that said, I do want to mention that any applications that were saved with the grid layout in a modern browser like Chrome, Firefox, or Edge, the applications will still render and run correctly in IE. For example, this is the application I just created a few minutes ago. It's running and it renders with the grid just like I set it up. You just cannot save a grid layout in IE 11. So I hope you find the new grid layout feature helpful when painting your applications. Please feel free to let us know your thoughts on the new enhancement. Thanks for watching and have a great rest of your day.